my friends, and welcome. Joanne here from the Rustic Farmhouse with my yard sale finds for this week. I'm going to start off with, I have an upcoming sale with Picasso Cat on Thursday on her channel, and I picked this up yesterday. It's a Fenton swung vase. A hobnail at the bottom. You see the Fenton label right there. This will be for sale on at the live sale on Thursday. And next I have these. I have actually two of these tins. This one's tea. Very mid-century. And then I have the coffee one. Here it is. Coffee. And these will be going up for sale in my eBay store. And if anybody's interested, you could just shoot me an email. I'll link all the information down below. Then I got this strainer. Enamel strainer. It does, you know, have some wear, of course. Very old. Vintage farmhouse style. Then I got this vintage lemon pitcher, and it is marked on the bottom, but I really can't make it out. But I just thought it was really pretty. How sweet for summertime. And that measures, needs to be clean, about 7 inches tall. So I thought that was really, really pretty. And next thing I have with Kathy in the sale that I got yesterday too, I'm only going to put one of these up because I'm limited for room here, is these mid-century bookends. And I got two of them, and they're both in excellent condition. I mean, there's a little wear to the bottom, but I mean, as far as there's no chips, I couldn't find any chips. This one needs to be cleaned a little bit in the back. I'll clean that off before, hopefully, before the sale. I can remember. And then this here, I picked up. It's a hat box, and this was free. So there was one yard sale I stopped at. Very clean inside. Everything just free on the thing. And this was another thing I picked up. How stinking cute is she? She's very heavy. She's cast. This mermaid. My goodness. She's been lifting her for weeks. Then I got this Cracker Jack vintage antique tin. The graphics are really good. I think it's super cute. You know, there's wear, of course, you know. I didn't do any research on anything, so I have no idea what year. But it's not as old as I thought, because it does have a barcode. So, and it does say this is a replica of an early 1900s Cracker Jack package, but that's okay. It's still really neat. Then I stopped at the thrift store because I wanted to drop something off because you have to go inside. Not drop something off, but when you get there. And I picked up this beautiful carnival glass vase. And I've seen these before with the daffodils. And I can't remember the pattern or who made this, but it's something I'll have to look up, and it's got to be cleaned before I sell it. Next, I picked up this, poor girl's eyes, this Betsy Wetsy. She has on the back of her head, she's ideal doll, made in the USA, 14. And I just thought she was absolutely cute. She does have a lazy eye, but I loved her anyways. So I got her, And I picked up a few other things at that yard sale that I'll be keeping, so I actually don't have them on hand. I picked up some old hymn books from like 1930s. I picked up some, they had some, no, it wasn't, that was at the other yard sale. I think there was like 4 hymn books, and then there was one from 1800s that was a large one. So I haven't decided what I'm going to do with them yet. I have to go through. I actually found a lot of books yesterday. The next thing I have is this. Hand-blown ball. Very pretty. This will be pretty actually for fall. I think they call it a witch's eye or something sometimes. But that was really pretty. Then I picked up these cabbage leaf or lettuce leaf bowls, and they are made in France, and there's 4 of them. I don't think any of them, let's see what this is, made in France. I don't think any of them have any condition issues. Not yet, anyways. And then along with them came the 4 plates. And it'll say made in France right there. So, sit them down. Next, I also got this bag. It is a Patricia Nash leather bag. So it was great for carrying my stuff in. It is got somewhere, but then I got this, and I also picked up some clothes for myself. I don't know, but you can see it. You know, it does say, you know, please return to Tiffany & Company, New York, 1925, which means it should be silver tone, right? Silver? It's silver. I'm not really much for jewelry, but I kind of had it in a lot, and so she just gave me a flat price for all of them. Next I have, and I just thought this was really cute, 3 hooks. Very cottage chic, shabby chic, whatever you want to call it. Then, I got this trinket dish, really cute, made in India. And how cute would that be? Like on the back of a bathtub or sitting on your sink, put your jewelry in, on your little tea lights in that, and I got this hook, wall hook, with their little piggies back and hooks, and I think the screws are attached, so I don't want to take it out of the bag. I know it's hard to see. But it's from San Francisco, but of course it's made in China. The company that sold it, SPI, from San Francisco. And I got this ladle. My boss got my receipt. This enamel ladle. And I thought this was really kind of charming. Oop. It's a pillbox with a telephone on it. And it's amazing that the receiver is still with it. But it's kind of like a little magnetic. And very clean inside. I mean, I You could tell if there's probably aspirin at the time. Because I'm going to say this is old. But I thought that was really neat. Here with me, folks. And I also got, I'm just going to pull out one of these because there's two of them, and these muffs, very Victorian. I don't see any tags or anything. I don't even know, but I just thought they would look really nice in a Victorian Christmas scene. So, and last I have these, I'll just hold one up, set of four cross stitch napkins, and I thought they were really pretty. I don't think they were ever used. You know, that's a lot of work. And that's it. I mean, I got some other things that were for myself, but I think that's pretty much everything. I mean, I got a lot of books and stuff. There was some, like, pastel chalks and stuff at the free yard sale, but I got that all. I don't even decide what I'm doing with it yet. I mean, whoever had that stuff from the free, I think they were, like, a teacher or something, because I picked up a lot of books. Like science books and stuff. So that's all I have for you. Until next week, I bid you have a good week and check me out on Kathy's channel this Thursday at 4:30. Thank you so much and have a wonderful, wonderful week.